Okay, so I have a spreadsheet on the right. We're going to act like I've just finished this and I'm ready to share it. And then I'm going to be sharing it with this person on the left. This is just two different Google accounts and I put them side by side so you can kind of see both sides of what's happening. So there's several different levels of sharing and we're going to go through each one of them, starting with the most restrictive all the way up to just sharing it with everyone. So on the right hand side, this is in the account where I created this spreadsheet. And right now I just want to share it with one person, which is going to be the person on the left. So you can go to the blue share button or you can go to file share, but we're just going to do it all from here for now. When I click on share, go ahead and click advanced as well. The different options are going to show up here. So we're just going to do everything from this larger screen and let's keep it real simple right now. You just want to share it with one person and it's going to be the person on the left. So just type in that person's email address, select it. And then you can decide whether or not that person gets an email. So obviously if it's just me sharing it with another account, you don't even need to have a check mark in there. But if you're sharing it with someone who's not expecting it or they're wondering when they're going to get it, this will send them an email and you can click add message and put a little custom message in here to explain what it is. When you add the names, you can choose whether or not they can edit the spreadsheet just like you, or they can just put comments in it, which is the second level, I would say. And the third level, the most restrictive, is that they can just view it. So Google Sheets will come up in their browser. They can move around, but they can't change anything. And you should also consider down here at the bottom whether or not you want the people that you shared it with to be able to share it with other people and whether or not they can download, print, or copy it. But right now we're just gonna share it with myself and I'm gonna turn off notify just because I don't wanna send myself an email. And click OK, and it's saying, are you sure you want to skip sending an invitation? But I'm sure, so I'm just going to click OK again. So I'm getting this warning because my account on the right is in a G Suite account, which is a business account, and it has extra security. So it recognizes that I'm adding someone outside of the organization. So it wants to prompt me to make sure that's OK. So I'll click yes. You might not get that if you're using a private email. And there, here it comes up who I shared it with. So I blurred myself out because it's my personal email. So just ignore that part. And if I go over to the left in the shared with me, it hasn't shown up yet. Refresh the screen. And there it is. It's article checklist. If I open that up, it's going to be the same thing. And notice that I can share it with other people because I didn't check this option down here to prevent that. And I see a nice picture of myself and my other self. So we're all ready to go. I can chat with my other self as well, but that's all relatively easy to figure out. So let's move on. Now let's explore some of the other ways to share this. So you might not want to be sharing it with just one person at a time. So let's use this option here for the specific people that can access. We're going to get away from specifics and we're going to change it. So beyond just specific people, you can share it with anyone at your organization if you're using a G Suite account. And the difference between these two is that the people in my G Suite account have to get a specific link in order to see it. This next one is anyone in my organization can search for it on their Google Drive and find it. Moving up to even less restrictive, anyone with the link that you provide, and we're going to get that link in a second, can access it. So it's on the internet, anyone can get to it, but the link is very long and it's random, so really no one's going to find it unless you share the link. And the last one is it's public on the web, meaning that link is on the web like this option, but it's indexed. So search engines can index it. People can search for whatever the subject of the spreadsheet is and look at it. So let's cancel out of the link sharing and see, this is the link that they're talking about. So if you copy this link and you open up a new browser window and you go to it, that's going to be a link to the spreadsheet. Now this window on the left is the account that I shared it with before, so it's going to open, but you notice I haven't shared it with anyone on the web yet. I'm going to do that right now. I'm going to share it with anyone on the web. I'm going to click save and grab this link again, and then I'm going to take my browser and I'll click done. I'm going to take my browser. I'm going to open up a new incognito window. So the internet doesn't know who is using this window. Could be anyone. I'm going to paste that link. I'm going to go to it and the spreadsheet's going to come up. So showing anyone can do this if you have that setting on. Now I'm going to go turn that setting off. Go back to advanced. I'm going to change it to only specific people. I'm going to save it. Now I'm back in the incognito window. I'm going to refresh it by using F5. And it's gone. You have to sign in to see it, and you could only see it if you signed in with those two particular accounts. So those are the basics for sharing your spreadsheet. So I hope that was helpful. If you want to see more videos like this, you can subscribe to my channel in the lower right-hand corner. Thanks.